All right, now that we've got the front view, a lot of it done, we've got the kind of the overall shape of it, we've got the chimney in, we need to do this water heater closet. We have kind of ignored it in the side view, and then we're about to do it in the front view. So let's just go ahead and do this. Now, of course, we're gonna go to our construction layers, and we're going to draw a vertical line, construction line. From here and here. So this is the wall and this is the overhang. I'm gonna go ahead and erase out these just so that we don't have any confusion. Now, if you notice when we look at it, I'm gonna come over to this one. Look at this, it's a 12-4. This is a 12 or a 412 pitch, and this is a 412 pitch. We've already drawn a 412 pitch. Why are we going to draw it over again? No reason at all. The only difference is this one has a 1'6" overhang and this one has a 1 foot overhang. So we're just going to be sneaky. It's not even sneaky. We're going to be smart. We're going to come over here. We're going to draw a line. I don't know, from here to here, let's say. I don't know why we have that. I'm gonna get rid of that one. Okay, we're gonna draw a line. Look at this, we're just gonna mirror. We have already got this thing drawn, wall and all. We're just gonna mirror that straight down the middle. Oh, hold on. This should be to right here. There. We're gonna mirror this straight down the middle. No, we don't want to erase the source object. Look, we have it drawn. The only difference is this is a 1 foot overhang instead of a 1'6" overhang. So that's no problem. We're just going to move this line, pick it up here, put it right there, and that's it. Trim. Done. Look at this. Trim. We just did it. I don't need this line anymore. Now this does go, go back to the elevations layer. We could draw just lines or a rectangle, whatever we want to do here, however you want to do it. Because you do have a hard edge between, you do have a hard edge where this wall is and then where that is. So we did it, like that was so easy to do just to get that little side water heater closet. Now we are gonna come in here and go back to our construction layer. Let's figure out where this goes in our side view. So same thing, V for vertical. And then look, here's our water heater, right here and right here. Those are the exterior walls of it. So we know where that is. But if we were to project this over to try to get the height of this line right here, if we were to project that over, it would be way too short. Because really what's happening is this line goes all the way until it touches the wall. You just can't see it because this overhang is covering it. So for now, what we're gonna do is let's just bring this, my little fillet command. This is actually how far up that roof goes. We're gonna end up trimming that back out, but we need to see where it actually, how far it goes when we use our construction lines. So I'm going to H for horizontal. I'm gonna project here and then these guys. Come back to my elevations, draw lines, draw rectangles, whatever it is that you see here, you can just draw it. That is how big these things are. Looking good. Oh, you know what I did not do? I'm gonna back this up. I did not project down my overhang, my roof overhang on those. So you remember that roof overhang when I look at it over here? It's got a 6-inch overhang on these sides. So when I come over here, I'm gonna go ahead and offset that 6 inches. This way, just the roof. This way and that way. Now I can draw it. Elevations. Lines, rectangles, however you wanna draw this. So from here to here, the skinnier part is the wall itself. So there's the skinnier part. Draw a line here to here, here to here. When I turn off that layer, you will see, beautiful, looking good. I don't need this anymore, so I'm gonna come in here and trim. That was just trying to get me behind the scenes so I can see where it actually touches the wall. So that looks good right there. Now I do have that 4-inch trim, that 3.5-inch trim here, and then actually in the house as well. So let's go ahead and do those. So we're gonna offset. Since we did it all 3.5 inches, we'll just do 3.5 inches here to here. We'll bring that in. I should have exploded that first so that my offset would come in correctly. Yeah, explode would have definitely been easier. But yeah, that looks good. So we're coming in here, we're looking at this. Actually, I just noticed my trim went all the way down. It does go all the way down right here because that's the corner of the foundation, right? But it doesn't actually have trim right there. So trim my trim. Yeah, this is looking good. Looking good. All right, so we've got it done right here. Next step, we're gonna go put in the doors and windows in that front view.